So HU80, and this is bar 23 that you're hearing in your cans, okay? And it will hopefully be in 5. I can't promise that. My entry point into writing the music for this series was really came from a series of chats with Gideon Bradshaw, who's the producer. And he and I were very concerned that all of the sound that we use within the music somehow blurred the distinctions between the field recordings, the kind of found sounds, and what's done in the studio with orchestras and players. And what was great, we had amazing location recording from people like Andy Padden.
So we were sitting in a restaurant in Peru, and there was a blind harp player playing away in the corner, and it just sounded fantastic and it was really captivating. And then suddenly we thought, wow, we're photographing all these local indigenous people, we should probably see what they sound like as well. Whose idea was that? Was it Gideon's?
So one of the things I was sent was a field recording done outside of Marrakesh. So they're Berber tribesmen, and one of them end up being the building blocks of the music.
On the Voyager Golden Records, there are a number of incredible recordings of humans that we sent out, the greatest hits, essentially, of Earth out into the cosmos.
With the Voyager Gold Discs, we have this incredible resource of music that's been sent out into space that actually covers every single sound world possible, whether human noises or whether Beethoven or Chuck Berry. And really, my starting point was to think, well, I'm going to use nothing on this that hasn't come either from Voyager or from being recorded in the field or from a real instrument. And that was really the starting point. Really good dynamics, everyone. Gorgeous.